Hello. If you ever need to bring a survey over from Kobo Toolbox to mWater or Solstice, you can do that with a few quick and simple steps. In this video, we'll take a look at how you can take a survey design out of Kobo and bring it into mWater, and then separately how you can bring existing data out from Kobo and import it into a survey in mWater. So let's begin. I'm here on Kobo Toolbox main site, and I'll sign in to my account as the first step. I've got a survey waiting there that I want to export. To export the design, it's very simple. I can hover over the selected survey and go to More Actions on the right side. There I can select Download XLS or XML, and I'm going to choose Download XLS as that's the best format for carrying over a design into mWater. It's going to trigger a download. And before we look at that, I'll just take a look at the survey design a little bit. So we have a water point functionality report here, let's say. So we've got a location question, some choice questions, text, more choice questions with conditionality linked into it, and so on. So I'd just rather bring this whole design over at once. What does that look like in the XLS format? It's going to look like this, with the type of question, the name, label, hint, whether it's required or not, and then specific kind of logic and constraints. Choices are automatically defined for single or multi-choice questions in a separate tab. So this is a quick overview of the XLS format across multiple tabs. So now I've got the survey design out of Kobo, not the data for the survey, just the design. So let me jump over into mWater to bring it in. So here I'm in mWater. I could be doing the same in Solstice, and I'm going to go over to Surveys, where I can either create a new survey manually, or in this case, import a survey design. If I click Survey Design Import, I can choose between a simple design, a basic spreadsheet with just columns and rows, or this more properly formatted XLS form with predefined choices, nicely, conditionality, many things in there. So I'm going to choose the XLS form importer. And then I just need to bring in the file. I'll pick the file, and it's going to import my draft survey. Now there might be some errors encountered during the import where there might be things like metadata that Kobo has and mWater doesn't have. For example, the start and end time of a survey. So they are just going to be ignored. And the rest of the questions are now here in mWater. With conditionality included, and as you can see, the structure is matching what's there. So I will now review that everything looks to be in order. This is a key step, because this survey is not saved until I click Save over here. I can view these errors again if needed. Now, this looks pretty fine to me. If I wanted to, I might change this basic water point location question into a water point site question at this point, because sites are a more powerful way of mapping things like water points. That's a key to how they make the most out of mWater. But for this example, I'll just want to copy over the survey as is. So I'm going to click Save, and now I have a proper mWater survey. I'm going to rename it the Two Point Functionality Survey 2023. Why not? And this completes the first part. In just a minute or so, we've got our survey design over. But if we look at the responses for the survey, of course, we don't have any data there. So if we have data in Kobo, can we bring it over into mWater quickly as well? The answer is yes, we can. So let's see how to do that. I'll jump back into Kobo here and look at my survey. Here there are a few ways to access the data you want to download. One is to go to the summary tab of your survey, open up downloads, and then just pick an XLS export. I'll take a new one for today. It's going to process it and then allow me to download it. I'll download the data. So now I have the Kobo export ready at hand. Broadly, the format is just the same as to import into mWater with columns and then rows of data. But now we need to get it into an import format that mWater will easily ingest. So we may need to do a couple of things. I'll jump back into mWater and I'll start importing data. I can import responses. I can click import responses here in the responses tab. And then here is where I can download an import template. We have further guides on how to import surveys and sites in more detail, but I'll just work through this example here. I'll also note that before you can upload the data, once you've completed the template, you need to activate and create a deployment. So we always need a deployment to import into, but we'll get to that. I'll download the template. So I get a blank Excel file with just the headers. So this is my target structure. So I need to populate and fill out this spreadsheet. So I can maybe have them side by side or one above the other. And then I just need to match over the data wherever possible. So start and end date. We don't have native fields for these in mWater, so you could just create extra date fields in the survey if you wanted to. But latitude and longitude for the water point locations, we do have. So I'll copy the latitude and longitude over here. Similarly, for the other questions that fill out the survey, I can just copy them and paste them in once I find the starting point. Great, because the order of the questions is the same. But note, there may be some cases where the mapping is a little bit different. So here we have this question. When is water not available from this source? And that is a multi-choice question. So the user would select all the months when water is not available. In this case, June, July, and August. In Kobo, it comes out with this space delimitation between the options, but also this split out choice where each option has its own column. And when it's not ticked, it gives a zero. And when it is ticked, it gives a one. So here it says for June, there's a one, so it's been ticked, July and August as well. So it's repeating the same issue. Whereas on the mWater side, I don't need to do it twice. I can just paste in to the multiple choice, make sure we're in the right spot. And then when is water not available from this source? June, July, August, and that should do it. So there may be cases like this. And then finally, we can add the last question. In the past 12 months, how long has the water point been? That should do it. Now let me just check the structure. Yes. So to me, the end result looks fine now. Let's try and import. I will create a deployment, as I was saying, just to test import, Kobo import. So this is the home and house of this data import. Now that we've created our deployment, I can go back to the survey responses tab and import responses using the import responses button. Here, I just need to complete step three, upload the completed template by selecting my deployment and then selecting my file. It shows me that I have three responses to import, which is correct. I'll do that and I'll see that three responses have been imported. And now the data that I have in Kobo is also in mWater, where I see them and I can review the responses right here. One at a time. So that's how easy it is to bring over survey designs and data. I would add as a tip that if you are adding and bringing over a complicated survey, it's definitely worth double checking that the conditionality and the options are all coming over properly. And when you're at this import step, if you're unsure what the data format is for a given data column in mWater, a good tip can be to deploy the survey and fill out a few dummy responses and then export those out. then the system will automatically show you the kind of format that it expects the data to be in. For example, that space delimitation we saw for the multi-choice field. But since there are many, many different question types, you may encounter a case where it will help to understand how mWater is parsing that data. Great. Well, that's all we had to cover today. Hopefully that was useful to you. You can bring data similarly from any platform, depending on how the data is exported and exportable from those platforms. We do have some general guides on data export and data import with mWater and Solstice, so I'll put those in the video notes. Remember, all the data that you collect in mWater belongs to you, and you can export it out at any point. So thanks for watching, and have a great day.